Today we're going to recognize that a digit in one place is 10 times the digit to the right, or the digit to the right is 1/10 of the digit to its left. Let me explain how this works. If you remember place value, you know that this is your ones place, tens, hundreds, thousands, ten thousands, hundred thousands. Take a look at the underlying digit 4. What is the value of that 4? Well, you know that this is the 10,000s place. So, the value of the 4 is 40,000. Now, to show you the actual scale of this digit being 10 times the amount of the digit to the right, let's show this in an expression. So, we know that this is 40,000. 40,000 equals, or you could say is, 10 times the digit to its right. Now let's look at this digit. The digit to the right is in the ones, tens, hundreds, thousands place. So therefore this 4 is worth 4,000. And when you multiply this expression 4,000 times 10, you get 40,000. Is 10 times the digit to its right. Now let's see the reverse. Or let's take and underline this digit. All right, so let's take a look now at the 4. If we were to write this number first, 4, and remember this 4 is worth 4,000. We could say 4,000 is and equals, remember it means is, 4,000 is, and then what is the value of this digit? 40,000 divided by 10. Now let's see if this actually makes sense. So 40,000 divided by 10 equals 4,000. So another way to write this is 40,000 divided by 10. Okay, so let's recap what we've said. So this 4 is worth 40,000. 40,000 is 10 times 4,000. So this 4 is 10 times the 4 beside it. Now, below, we've said this 4 is worth 4,000. 4,000 is 1/10 of this 4. So, if you wanted to back up and show how you could work this out, we actually use mental math. This is how we worked this problem out. We just did it mentally. All right. Tell me what you notice about when we multiply. Do you notice how we're adding something? All right. So remember, when you are multiplying zeros and you're by 10, you just add one additional zero. Now, what are we doing here? Mentally, do you notice what's happening? One less zero, right? Okay, so 40,000 divided by 10, you're taking 10 away. So that's your mental math part of it. That will make it faster by using those skills. Okay, so now I would like to show you a non-example. Let's take a look at the same number, 344,781. The question is this 7 10 times the value of the digit to its right? Let's take a look. So what is the value of the 7? Ones, tens, hundreds. So the 7 is worth 700. Let's take a look at the value of this digit. Ones, tens. So the 8 is worth 80. Now, is 700 10 times 80? No. So, what are you noticing about these digits right here? Because this is really important with place value understanding and knowing that one digit is 10 times the digit to its right. You're noticing they have to be the same, right? Okay, so unless they're the same, one can't be 1/10 of the other or 10 times the other. All right, so that's just a good thing to keep in mind. All right, so let's take a look at another example. So when you look at this number, you notice you have a digit in the millions. So let's read the number 5,628,849. Now, previously in the video, we talked about how the digits have to be the same. So do you notice which two are the same? Yeah, the eights, right? All right, so we're gonna take a look at the eights. Look at the value of this 8 right here. The value is 8,000, right? So this value of this 8 is going to be 10 times more, or is it 10 times less? Which is it? Is it 1/10 of this number, or is this 10 times more? So let's write it out as an expression. This 8 is 8,000. 8,000 is 10 times, and this is, the value of this 8 is 800. So let's see if this makes sense. So when you multiply with zeros, 800 times 10, you're just adding a zero. That makes sense, doesn't it? Okay, so we know that this is correct. So 8,000 is 10 times 800. Now, let's see, say this in reverse. Let's look at this digit right here. We'll erase this one. Let's take a look at the 800. 800 is, and let's put the value of the other digit, 8,000 divided by 10. Let's see if that makes sense. Now, with division, it's the opposite. We add a zero for multiplication, but we take away a zero for division. So 8,000 take away a zero is 800. So that also makes sense. So this 8 is 1/10 of this 8. Does that make sense? All right, I think you got it. Now, let's do a challenge. Let's see if you can take this understanding, but what if the digits are not side by side? Let's see if you can apply your knowledge with the digits side by side to something a little more difficult. Let's try this one. 7,925,453. Now, do you see any digits that repeat or are the same? Looks like the fives are the same. All right, so let's take a look at those fives. Let's look at the value of this particular five. Ones, tens, hundreds, thousands. This particular five is 5,000, correct? So let's put our equal sign and write an expression. 5,000 is it 10 times the value of this 5? It's something, so let's put a blank. Something times, and what's the value of this 5? It's 50, isn't it? So here's our question mark. If you put 10 times 50, that would be 500. Does that make sense? No, this is 5,000, right? So I bet you've already figured it out. So what do you need to go in the blank? Would 100 work? 100 times 50. So anything times zeros, you're gonna add two zeros, right? So 50 times 100 would be 5,000. So this 5 is 100 times more than this 5. So depending on how spread apart your numbers are, As long as it's the same digit, you can figure out how many times greater a number is than another number. Now you can do the division as well. You can take the 5, and this is a 50, right? And you can say 50, this is 5,000 divided by what? So you already know the answer, don't you? Because we just did it. But if you divide by 100, you would take 2 zeros away and you'll get the answer of 50. So it works out whether you're taking away 2 zeros or whether you're adding 2 zeros. All right? Does it make sense? I hope so. All right. So try some at home and watch the next video. We'll learn some more.